So let's move on to the second part of the topic. I know you wanted to talk about some common themes of third-party PPC integration. And I assume they're gone. I guess they didn't die. That's good. But people don't die in the PPC world either. But in any event,
it's a quick procedure.
PPC integration, it could really make or break you. You do it wrong, you could probably get screwed out of thousands, millions of dollars.
Exactly.
Yep. Feel free to what's your thoughts on that?
Yeah. This is a conversation that I wanted to have as well, because it's important to understand what these paid search integrations are offering and what you should be looking for when you consider them, right? So there's a couple of things you should be considering. The first and probably the most important to me personally is a good solid customer service team, or customer success team is I think what they call it. And the reason for that is because the onboarding experience with some of these can be a little rough. Like, you don't, when you're starting out on a brand new integration, you may have never used it before, and you're going to want a team to back you and help you get integrated with it and onboard that product. So that would be the first thing that I would really recommend to look into. Can you get a hold of somebody on the phone? If not, do you really want to consider them? What happens when you have a question, right? Other things you want to consider is, just what are the capabilities, right? Does it have more capabilities or less than the other one you're looking at? And is the price difference substantial between those two? So those are some other things to consider as well. And then there's a lot of people out there that are also going to say, well, I could do that with a script, or you can do that natively in the platform, right? But what you need to consider is the time savings of not reinventing the wheel as well, right? So maybe the tool is expensive, but perhaps the time savings that you have will create substantial value for your client, and you'll be able to move the needle in other ways. So those are definitely some things to consider. There's certainly got to be plenty other ones as well. So something I've been thinking about is, we're going through seismic changes in the industry, right? It feels like we're maybe losing a little bit of control with the loosening of match types, the obscuring of keyword data. And I've been thinking about how these paid search integrations might be able to give you actually back a little bit of that control, which is interesting. So I won't disclose any specific platforms, because I don't want to come off as biased here. But there are platforms that allow for you to remain in an ECPC strategy. I know people are hearing ECPC right now and raising an eyebrow. They're like, manual bidding, why? But they allow you to use manual bidding, ECPC, and then layer on top of that some machine learning, which in this case would be like a portfolio bid strategy. And what it does is it gives you the ability to define a target such as target ROAS, and it will make its ECPC bidding decisions based off of that target ROAS that you set. So it's kind of interesting. You're not necessarily directly using a target ROAS or target CPA strategy directly in the platform, but you're using automation layering to help make these bids for you. And the reason why I'm saying, it gives you more control is because FredValet's posted, or Optimizer posted, a beautiful table the other day that showed you the different bid adjustments that you can make, right? Based on what bid strategy you're using. And some of the smart bidding ones actually don't allow for control of certain bid adjustments. However, if you're an ECPC, you do have pretty much full control of all your bid adjustments. So in this case, that automation layering I discussed earlier allows you to stay in ECPC, define a target ROAS, and also retain control of your bid adjustments. And that's something that, I find really exciting, and I think people should look into more ways of gaining back some of this control.
It's interesting, because this stuff changes all the time.
Right.
And as you were driving here, Google just announced changes to both those things. So I don't know if that's gonna mess up any of the platforms that are managing this.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully not. But the more I speak to paid search experts, the more they keep saying is, we need more control, and Google's taking away control from us. And
right.
Any ways we can find ways to gain more control over our keywords, mm-hmm. and our ads, we're going to take advantage of that as any way we can. I believe Google just made a change as you were driving here. I'm not sure of the exact details. I should have studied up on that before. Literally, as I was walking down, they made a change. So I'll put a link in that below, and hopefully we'll.
Would it happen to be the rolling of T ROAS into maximize conversion value?
So you were reading that while you were driving, I guess. Yeah. So you want to explain that or no?
So I haven't been following it all that closely, but what I will say is it doesn't seem like that large of a shift to me, because you're still going to you're still going to be able to define what your like what ROAS you're shooting for within that maximized conversion value strategy. It's just like they're combining the two essentially, and you can. It seems like you're going to be able to tick a box to say whether you'd like to define your ROAS there or not.
I think the issue that some paid search people are having with it is the reporting side. You're not going to be able to see exactly what's going on with the keywords. I believe. I think Greg Finn was going off about this. After Jenny Marvin tweeted about it, because now she's at Google,
yeah.
She's over on our side, she's on their side. You hear that, Jenny?
And we're looking at you, Jenny.
But hopefully it won't be a big deal, and hopefully we'll be able to dig into that data and get what you need.
Yeah, yeah. Anytime there's any obscuring of data or your ability to view the data is more difficult, that's definitely something that I take to the heart. You know, I want to be able to view the data as much as possible and create thorough analysis for the clients.
Cool. Anything else you want to talk about on that topic, or we pretty much got it for now?
I think that was definitely the bigger portion that I wanted to hit. I mean, we could definitely talk about some of the common themes of the integration. So, for example, a lot of these platforms offer a lot of the same stuff. They offer reporting, bid management. They'll oftentimes offer you recommendations outside of that of which Google Ads will recommend. For example, perhaps your search partners aren't performing well. Google Ads tends to recommend always to, you know, auto apply those search the search partners. However, there's some third party integrations that might highlight that's not such a great idea. Maybe you need to turn them off. You know, your CPA is significantly higher than that of which the just regular Google network is offering. So that those are definitely some things to consider. Like you'll definitely want to make yourself aware of all these different commonalities when you're going into the decision making process for choosing a third party integration.
Right. And what about people wanting to do this on their own? It probably makes sense for not to just be thrown in on this and maybe get some advice from a consultant, because there's a lot of technicality around Google auto applying recommendations or putting you into certain bid strategies that might not be the best for you.
Right. So, and that's why it's so important to work with like practitioners that perhaps have experience with multiple integrations, right? Because they might know what's best suited for that client in specific. Whereas somebody with no experience, they're just going in there testing, right?
So, right. Yeah. Testing and wasting a lot of money. Cool. Excellent.
Right.
I appreciate you coming out here.
Yeah.
Can you please tell people in this camera how they can learn more about you, maybe follow you on Twitter or social media?
Yeah, definitely reach out to me via Twitter at Brett Bedofsky or LinkedIn, again, Brett Bedofsky. Always happy to chat anything and everything PPC. And if there's anything going on in the community that you want me to get involved with, I'm happy to get involved.
Cool. Thank you so much. I appreciate
it. Thank you. Yeah, it's been a pleasure being here.